Welcome to Exposure. This is the show where we showcase local films with local filmmakers. I'm your host, Steve Rodojev, and today we're here with Jim Aponte. Jim, thank you for being on the show.
Nice to meet you.
Let's get into some of your background. Where are you from?
I'm from Toledo, Ohio. Grew up in Sylvania, went to Sylvania Northview High School, and then I got my undergrad at the University of Toledo.
How did you get your start in filmmaking? What really inspired you to become a filmmaker?
Well, films have always been like a big part of my life. Since I was a kid, you know, I've watched films, I've consumed a lot of films, a lot of films and media, but I never really wanted to like get into filmmaking right away. It was more of just, I liked watching these things and, you know. Yeah, I was appreciating, all the fast action and explosions and stuff like that. Like Star Wars was a huge one when I was a kid. And I didn't really get into filmmaking until later. I originally wanted to be a writer.
Oh, okay.
Like just write stories and create worlds and characters that way. And it wasn't really until I started watching behind-the-scenes featurettes of some of my favorite films. Like the one I remember distinctly is James Cameron's Aliens.
They had
the big like Alien quadrilogy that came out. It was first of its kind. Had the super huge collection with all these special features with all four Alien films. It was great.
So definitely, your genre is basically sci-fi. You really love sci-fi. Is that just from watching the films as a kid? Is that what really inspired you to tell stories in that genre?
Yeah, partially. Science fiction has always been a genre that's really captured my imagination, and it captures a lot of other people's imagination, because you can explore all different types of characters and worlds and things we don't see in everyday life, but we can still have messages about the world we live in right now, and that's really exciting about it.
What are some of the other duties? You said you direct and write. Do you edit your own films as well?
Yeah, I edit my own films. I do a lot of the sound design elements, laying that stuff down. I color grade, and I also do some special effects work as well.
You do short films. Let's talk about your first ever film project that you've done.
Okay, yeah, so the one that counted for, I had done a lot of work in high school, like playing around with HDV video and stuff like that, and just getting some friends together for some classes and making videos that way. But none of it really officially counted for real until I became an undergrad at the University of Toledo, and we were given film stock and actual film lenses and light meters and light kits, and we had to come up with this sort of surrealist short film that we had to do. That was the parameters of the project. The cheapest film stock we could get was like Tri-X Reversal, so that's a black and white film stock, because that was the other challenging thing too. The first official short film is we had to pay for our own film stock and processing and development.
Nothing was free, huh?
Yeah, nothing's free.
Oh, that's rough.
And then there's no dialogue because, it's not like DSLR cameras where you have the microphone plug in the back or something like that. There's no audio plug into this Bolex camera you have to load film into. It's all completely silent when you shoot it. If you want to get dialogue, you need a separate recorder, or you have to do Foley and get sounds in later. And rather than deal with that hassle, because I really wanted to get all my visual stuff figured out first, I figured, we'll make it silent and go from there. It's a surrealist project, so it's I went more into the realm of surrealist nightmares and dreamscapes, that sort of thing. I was very influenced by German expressionist films that I had seen, like The Cabinet of Dr. Caligari, which is a very influential film for its time. And so basically that trickles down into Limbo combined with this love of Alien. I wanted to do something sort of in this horror, surrealist horror genre. And basically it's just about kind of this guy's nightmare he's experiencing, but it might be real, it might not be real.
Yeah, you definitely play around with that that world of, Limbo. You don't know if it's real or not.
Yeah, so. Exactly.
Well, let's take a look at the realism or unrealism of Limbo.